You told me earlier that since you moved 6 years ago, you've been home 3 times.
Yeah, three times before this.
Work yun or half work, half vacation?
Always work, half vacation.
Okay.
Except for, there was one time it was really just for my mom's birthday last year. So, yeah.
And speaking of that, because your mom nga is, you mentioned you have a lot of family members who are also in California, but your mom decided to stay home. She really loves the Philippines. Well, but how do you, like, stay in touch pa rin?
Ah, yeah. Well, FaceTime, Messenger, we keep in touch with her. We have a vibrant group chat with the kids and with her as well.
Yeah.
You know, for her, it wasn't an automatic na I want to bring in, let's go, because my opportunities and were limited to my wife and the kids.
Yes.
But I could have if I wanted to eventually. And she's like, no, I'm happy with life here. I'm settled here with my friends, my area. I'm used to my life here.
Yeah.
My sister naman is back in the Philippines, so she's back and forth
more
here. Settled dito. You know, it's the reality of life for a lot of Filipino families who have kids who migrate.
Yes.
And, you know, they're like you guys, you know, you have your two siblings abroad, and you're here.
Yeah.
The other one is a friend of mine. I've hung out with him a lot, JC.
Yes, also
which
in California.
From our college days. Narumakit
din yan sa mga TFC subscribers na nanonood ngayon, kung naalala nyo ang, I don't know if it was just in North America, ang Adobo Nation.
Yep.
Yes, nag-host ang kuya ko sa Adobo Nation. Yep. Minsan nga na tutuwa siya, nag-recognize daw siya sa going out in San Francisco. Oh, ikaw yung sa Adobo Nation.
Okay.
Sabi niya, wow, still got it.
Oh my goodness, JC.
Yes, my brother JC. Na kayo actually ang unang magkakilala before.
Nauna ba siya mag-hosting before you?
Yes, siya ang reason kung bakit sabi ko, maybe I can
try
do
it
this.
Out.
Yeah, pero kayo ang nauna in the sports world, syempre.
I had said he was part of NBA also.
Yes. Kayo ang unang nag-meet.
Yep.
Oo, yung mga older nating TFC subscribers, familiar tong mga sinasabi namin terms sa inyo.
Oh my goodness, lalo ng mga mahilig sa sports.
Yes. Yep. So, I guess before wrapping this up for this part of our conversation, a lot of people watching right now are still in that adjustment period of moving to wherever they are in the world. What's your advice, especially pag buong pamilya yung lumipat, just like you did?
Well, take it one day at a time. It can be overwhelming. Be present with everything coming at you. Don't try to solve all the problems and challenges all at once. And don't try to solve it on your own. You have support within your family. And also, seek that out.
Yeah.
Before you move palang, seek out that familiar support that you may find, whether it's direct family or friends of friends. Dami ganun eh.
Yeah.
Yung paglilipat ko, oy, kumare, yung pamangkin ni kuwani, ganyan, lilipat dyan, tulungan nyo. And they're so supportive.
Yeah.
They're super supportive. They'll just go all out and welcome you and help you adjust. So that's always there. Don't take that for granted. Take that opportunity. And, you know, just enjoy the moment, every moment. And if there, it's stress, there is stress.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because usually it's for work, diba?
Yes,
so there's going to be work and adjusting and all that. But just try to slow down and take it one day at a time. And
yeah. Totoo yun. Such great advice. And iba talaga yung warmth ng Pinoy wherever they are in the world. Now we're going to take a look back at your long career sportscasting to being a news anchor, broadcast journalist. Now heading many projects in TFC and the global scene. Okay, we're gonna show you pictures.
Oh my goodness.
Time for throwbacks. Okay,
let's
so
go.
We want to start from the very beginning. Mm-hmm. In fairness, I'm so impressed na nahanap nila to ha. Okay, so the first
good job, research
picture,
team.
Please. Actually, ang galing talaga
wow.
ng research team. Oh my
okay.
God!
Look at all that hair and that baby cheeks. Wow. So the NBA, although I'm not in any of these photos,
but
the NBA was my first ever TV job.
Yes.
I graduated from La Salle.
Mm-hmm.
I was coaching basketball in La Salle Green Hills.
Yes.
And I was like, I'm enjoying this, but I'm not going to survive on this salary alone.
Mm-mm.
Maybe there's something I can do, something else part-time.
Yeah.
I saw a couple of friends and even a relative doing this. Mm-hmm. Soria Trillo was doing this
already. Right.
And then I had my cousin Vanessa Mayuga.
Yes.
You know Vanessa?
Yes, I do.
She was doing PBL naman, courtside.
Okay.
So I actually applied to both.
Right.
At the same time, and then I got the NBA gig. I trained with them. Went on air for about a month.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's a funny story that few people know.
Uh-huh.
Then the PBA called me.
Okay.
And gave me the opportunity to do analysis.
Yeah.
So I asked the NBA folks if I could take the chance, and Peter Musing at the time and Mr. Cruz, the dad of Ron Cruz, said, okay, but the doors are open for you to come back anytime. And I went to the PBA, and a lot of sports fans know me from the PBA.
Yes,
from the year 2000
yes.
to about 2003-ish. Mm-hmm. Paolo Trillo and mm-hmm. I, of course, you know Paolo, we were the youngest sportscasters at the time. I don't know if there were younger ones that came above. We were 22 yeah, years old. Imagine. Yeah, bata-bata namin. Tapos ina-analyze namin yung mga album patrimonyo.
Correct.
Good Lord, ang tapang niyo. Buti walang social media at the time, kundi I don't know what it would be like. But that was a start. Sportscasting was a start of the TV career, and I started to really enjoy this TV thing. Like, this is fun.
Yeah. But then, of course, parang talagang dumadalo yung sports sa iyong dugo, mm-hmm. literally because of your dad. Parang yun ang talagang exposure mo to the love of the game, mm-hmm. like we said earlier. Pero did you know that you could host? Like, nag-host-host ka na ba sa school dati? Or
no,
talagang
you know,
sumabot
started. It started with when they made me host, like, all-star events in the PBA. So I was a game analyst, not even an anchor, analyst ako. And then sila Direk Abet Ramos at the time, they're like, you seem to have a personality. Let's try to put you hosting the all-star events.
Yeah.
Which is more freewheeling, more fun.
Yeah.
And then I did that, and I did some segments. I'm like, I felt segment hosting for the first time.
Oh.
I was like, ooh, I like this. I mean, this is different.
Yeah.
So after that, I was very fortunate to a friend who was a PBA writer at the time, and the showbiz people know him now, Ambet Nabus.
Yes.
Ambet got me a gig to host a 3-on-3 tournament in Alabang Town Center. And like a whole day event.
Okay.
And I was like, ooh, I really like this too. It was like corporate hosting.
Yeah.
So doon nagsimula. And then it was just my goal. I want to be more than just a sportscaster. I want to do other TV hosting gigs. And I probably manifested it.
I just
really thought it through and through
until
I got the chance to do a morning show
at
the other side.
Yeah.
And the rest is history.
Galing, no? Technically, parang racket lang, isang racket, dalawang racket, until parang naging career na siya. I super, super relate to that.
Yep.
And I mean, to those kasi who don't know the difference.
Mm-hmm.
So when you started, you're an analyst, meaning may actual commentator na nag-host, tapos tinatanong ka lang, ano sa tingin?
Tagasagot lang ako ng question
niya.
Maganda yung play na yan, maganda yung pasa na yan.
Yun ang analyst, nag-a-analyze lang ng game.
Ito dapat gawin niya. So there's no hosting involved.
Yeah. Until, ayun na nga, you did MBA, you worked PBA.
And then when I moved here, UAP.
Yes, that's right, UAP. Your batch is sina...
Well, Boom was like forever. Jude? He's still around.
Yes.
You know, nagsalisi kami ni Jude. Hindi kami nagkaabot ni Jude and Miko. Not until the latter part, Miko came back to ABS Sports.
Correct.
But this Boom throughout, Ronnie Magsanok, Eric Tipan. Those are the early guys that I was in 04 when I went back to ABS through sports first and then the morning show.
Ang saya.